Hello viewers, welcome to the Standard 10 subject Science. In our previous video, we have started the chapter number 3, Metals and Non-Metals. In this chapter, we have performed the activities and learned about the physical properties of metals. The first one we have seen is luster, then hardness, malleability and ductility. These four physical properties we have learned in our previous videos. Today, in this video, we are going to perform another activity, and which is for the physical properties. Metals are conductors of electricity and heat. So, in this video, we will perform activity and we will learn that metals are conductors of electricity and heat. So, let us start the activity. Here on your screen, you can see the figure for this activity. First of all, what are the things that we need to perform an activity? We will collect, then set up an electric circuit as shown in this figure. Now, let us start the procedure of this activity. In this figure, you can see we have taken a battery. Its one end is connected with clip. You can see its one end is connected with clip and second end is with bulb and switch and again with clip. Now, place the metal to be tested in the circuit between terminal A and B as shown. Whatever the sample we will put here to test. For example, let us place a piece of copper. Now, for example, we are going to take the copper between terminal A and B. Then we will turn on the switch. Then you can see that due to the current passing through the battery, the bulb is illuminated. So, bulb will light up. You can observe from this activity. It means that this piece of copper is good conductor of electricity. After putting the copper between terminal A and terminal B, the bulb will light up. So, we can say that the copper is good conductor of electricity. Now, if you replace the copper with plastic or rubber, then the bulb will not light up. It means that plastic and rubber cannot carry electricity, so they are insulated with electricity. It means rubber and plastic are insulator of electricity because the current cannot pass through the rubber or plastic. So from this activity, we can say that if the current will pass through the substance, then that substance is called the good conductor of electricity, and the current will not pass through the substance, then that substance is called the insulator of electricity. From this activity, we have observed. This activity you have performed in your previous classes. It means the class 9. Now, let us understand something else. See your home's wiring. For wiring, copper wire are mostly used. For wiring, copper wire are mostly used. Now, this wire is kept open and accidentally any person touches this wire, then that person may get current. This is because of copper is a good conductor of electricity. Therefore, it is important to keep in mind that a copper wire should be coated with a substance that does not conduct electricity. So, in our home, in the wiring, copper wire are used. If the wire is kept open accidentally, any person touches the wire, the person may get current. Therefore, there is a coating of any substance which is not a good conductor of electricity. So, you can see the figure of the open wire and the coated wire. The wires that carry current have a coating of polyvinyl chloride, it means PVC or a rubber like material. So PVC is used to coat the wires. For that, polyvinyl chloride or a rubber is used which are insulated with electricity. So PVC or rubber, they are insulated with electricity, they cannot pass through the current. So we can use PVC or rubber. It means that current is not passing through rubber or PVC. Now if you will touch rubber, then you don't have current. Like that, we can save ourselves. Now, let us understand something else, which is, first of all, can you tell me what happens when metals are hit on the surface? Do they produce a sound? The metals that produce a sound on striking a hard surface are said to be sonorous. Now, can you now say why school bells are made of metals? Let's talk about the bells of school and temple. When you hit it, then it produces a sound. Therefore, they are made of metals. So, school bells and temple bells are made of metals. When we hit it, it produces sound. So, in this video, we have performed an activity and also learned the physical properties of metals, that metals are good conductors of electricity and heat. Hope you have understood very well. Thank you.